rights we submit to players like Johnny Manziel, Tim Tebow, Colin Kaepernick?
Well, I think this, that one of the things, when I said the quality of human being is very important and just as important as the quality of the player, what I mean by that is you want someone who does not have any criminality whatsoever associated with them. And in the XFL, even if you have a DUI, you will not play in the XFL. So that would probably eliminate some of them. Not all of them. If Tim Tebow wants to play, maybe he could very well play.
Well, that does it for Johnny Manziel. Victor Cruz jumping in the studio here with me, current. We just talked about this, NFL receiver Victor Cruz. By the way, okay, current. So what's the football plan, Victor?
The football plan is to give it one more shot next year, see if I land, stick anywhere, put my best foot forward. And if not, I'll hang up and just have me on your little cane show. You got a seat for me here already. I'm already good.
You said hi to me out there, so I guess you've seen me on TV before.
1,000%. I've mainly just argued with Stephen A. Smith a bunch of times. That's very entertaining.
So here's your opening for the little cane show. Just yell at me for the next 10 minutes, and you got a seat.
And I'm in.
All right, wait. So you said give it one more shot. What about the XFL?
XFL, 2020, correct, is the starting year for this? So that gives me 2 years. I'll be 33. Probably not going to happen for me in the XFL. But I do find it interesting that Vince is coming back with the XFL. I think it's a better time for the XFL this time around. I don't think we were ready for it back then when it first came about. I think it's a different time now, but taking on guys that have gotten DUIs, that's like,
Johnny didn't last 5 minutes. Johnny tweeted XFL 2020 and then at Vince McMahon did, and Vince McMahon minutes later said, yeah, they'll be with DUIs. Short XFL
Ouch.
Career for Johnny.
Ouch.
You said now they're more ready for it than they were in the 90s. Why? What's changed?
I just think with social media and the way that you can become, I think XFL is going to be, remember guys like He Hate Me,
of course,
and guys that had it on the, those things are going to be huge in social media. Those little plays or things that they say, I remember those guys being mic'd up the whole game, and you can hear them talk, and hear them talk smack to each other and score touchdowns. And those are things people want to hear. I mean, do they want to hear them from guys in the XFL that they may or may not know? I think that's where they have to find the balance. So guys that they know and guys that that they don't know, people will have to get to know, and how vested and interested are people in that in the XFL is going to be the question.
I think, you know, you're talking about, are we in Victor Cruz in the studio on the Will Cain show. I actually think you're right that we're more ready for it now than we were in the 90s. I think much of society has become a little more WWE. And that's not all positive, trust me.
Yep.
But it's not all negative either. I mean, look, First Take is a lot of disagreement, but it's also a lot of fun and just kind of letting your ego fly.
Yeah.
That's not all bad. You know, you're bringing people to conversations that are entertaining. If Vince McMahon can make football, I love the NFL.
Mm-hmm.
If he can make it entertaining, this might be the day and age for it. Let it fly.
I agree. Is someone going to like Stone Cold stun somebody on the field? Like, that's what I'm waiting for. I'm waiting for somebody in the end zone. You know, and there's no holds barred in this. You're going to do whatever you want. Obviously, there's going to be rules and pass interference, things like that. I hope. You never know. But I think it's going to be a lot more fun for players to go out there, play some ball, and just be free and be themselves.
Okay, so let's take the XFL out of it. If Victor Cruz could have played for any franchise in the NFL, your choice, let's make all the contract values the same, okay?
Okay.
What franchise was it you look back and go, I wish I could have played for them?
Oh, man. I'm honest, yo. It's real. I mean, when you look at it all, right, you look at where I came from, 15 minutes away from Giants Stadium, to have the ability to join the team as an undrafted free agent, make the team, you know, just fight for my life each and every week. Like, okay, I'm on the team, but I can be replaced at any time. Fight for my life, you know, be on IR that rookie season, come back the next year, win a Super Bowl, and just have great years to come after that. It was just, you can't paint the picture any other way. You know what I mean? I did grow up a Cowboy fan.
There we go.
Due to my dad, I had no choice. Like, there was no option for you when you grow up with my father. You become a Cowboy fan. And then we've always respected the Giants, of course. But obviously, as I became an adult and joined the organization, it was a different story.
Okay, so now that you got on my good side with your little Cowboys.